of this meet and also the president of Cardiology Society of India, Hyderabad chapter, Telangana state. I'm told this is the first conference of Telangana state here. Distinguished friends on the dais, equally distinguished friends sitting in the audience. I find amidst the audience the most respected cardiologist, Dr. Krishnamraju. Not because he happens to be my doctor, but I always keep on hearing about him, at least for the last quarter of a century, and the services rendered by him to the humanity and to the needy. In his presence, I dare not say anything about cardiology except to receive his advice every 2 months. He looks after me, and in a way, I stand before you, in which there is what you call unmentionable and uncountable contribution of Dr. Krishnamraju. I was really surprised when Dr. Shiv Kumar rang me up and said, requested me to be with you for a couple of minutes to inaugurate this conference. During the discussions when he came to me to extend invitation, we had a brief chat where this topic of what you call internet came up for consideration. How it is influencing the course of events and thinking processes in every profession. I have expressed my view with Dr. Shiv Kumar. I said it cuts both ways. I have a cardiology problem. I can't just go to the internet, look into it, and start treating myself. Equally, the cardiologist cannot just go to the internet and find a solution which one of their patients may be facing, which may be peculiar of its own kind. It depends upon one's own experience, commitment, learning, and more than anything, the humane aspect in the cardiologist. Science and technology, yes, leaps and bounds, there are developments. But the question is, application of the advancement of science and technology to a particular given case. That's where the role of cardiologists and that's where the role of doctors come into play. Not that every day the doctor reads something. Of course, you have to read and you are reading, all of you. But reading something and just making an experiment perhaps is not the answer. It's application, that's where your skill, your own experience, your own knowledge comes. But I must mention, with a little bit of hesitation, that like all other profession, including the profession to which I belong, your own profession also is afflicted by certain undesirable aspects of the matter, where the service is being increasingly viewed as a business or as a commerce. Maybe the promotion of many corporate hospitals may have made their own contribution in that direction. I am not blaming them. They are also serving the people, no doubt about it. But that human touch, which is very important while attending on a patient, is nowadays missing. I find, you must all forgive me because once again I take the name of Dr. Krishnan Raju. When I enter his chamber, he's alone. While I enter into chambers of some other cardiologists whom I know, to whom I have great regard and respect, A comes and takes my blood pressure, which he is not supposed to do. B comes and looks after something, and C comes and looked after something, that just jot down some notes. And the concerned cardiologist looks into that and scribbles something. I think this type of practice is affecting the credibility of the profession itself. Ward boys cannot take the blood pressure readings, and somebody else cannot look into my pulse and say what is it and what is not. And invariably there are mistakes which I have noticed, and I have discussed with my personal physicians and cardiologists that this practice must be stopped. Maybe all of you are overburdened, but still that is not the answer. Touching the patient, talking to him, and giving necessary confidence to the patient, I think is an integral aspect of the treatment, not merely prescribing the pills and advising what to do and what not to do. Perhaps some of those things we can even learn from internet. But the question is, what is the particular patient requires? What is his way of life? What has been his attitude? How he is taking his disease? These are all the aspects that go into treatment of a patient. This is one aspect of the matter. And all of you, with your vast experience, are aware it is not as if the disease of cardiology is prevalent only in the metropolitan cities like Hyderabad and Mumbai, Delhi, or big cities. It has become a common problem even in rural areas and villages where there are no proper facilities, and many people die without even knowing ultimately as to what was the cause. Telugulo chepparante ayedo maya rogam vachindandi untuntene kurchonu sanipoyindi em ledhu baane unnadu urukane sanipoyindandi. I think this is one area the distinguished cardiologist and seniors should pay some attention and devise some mechanism whereby they reach out to the needy and deserving people, particularly coming from weaker sections of the society in the rural areas.